Hey everybody, Dutch Sense here. 11:34 p.m. Central Time on Saturday, September 26th, 2015, going into Sunday, September 27th. And I wanted to bring you guys up to date on the situation that's been developing here over the past 24 hours since I issued my last earthquake forecast. First of all, several of the areas that were forecast have already been hit. Very ironically, of course, the East Coast was just struck in eastern New York State at a depth of about 13 kilometers below a reservoir. Very rare earthquake struck. And if you go watch the forecast, talking about the Northeast seeing 3.0 earthquake activity. And it's been a while since New York saw that. But also, want to draw your attention to some other activity that struck over the past 24 hours. 4.9, borderline 5.0, originally 5.0, downgraded to 4.9. Struck at Baja California. And a 3.4 struck in northern Arizona. I want to show you guys what's at this location. It's really interesting to point out where this earthquake struck, why it struck, compared to the earthquake forecast, and what we were expecting. But I don't want to spoil it for you, so we'll just go ahead and put the coordinates in here, and we'll hit search. I recommend you do this for any earthquake you see that stands out as odd. And we'll just back this out ever so slightly. And you'll see this is on the edge of the San Francisco Volcanic Center. And this is the location that actually sent out the volcanic plume. Several months ago, you guys may remember, I caught a lot of hell in the media and everything else. But now, here we are, and this is the location that just saw a very rare earthquake. And I'd say the two are related. Of course, we see this. This is all lava flow, guys. This, no doubt about it. You can see these. You may have to watch this full screen to get a good idea of all the craters. But we're talking about several hundred craters out here in the desert. This whole location here. This whole location here. This whole location up here. Several of these. We can zoom in on this. SP crater. Okay. And we have several old weathered flows over here. You can still make out the butte on this there. Here, let's zoom in so you can see that. You can make out the crater shape on those. Very, very old and weathered. And the old lava flows on here, you can see, bordered along here going up to the north. So, this is the spot that saw the plume and now a very rare earthquake. And we were expecting to see earthquake strike at the volcanic locations on the west coast and along the edge of the craton up the east coast. The 5.0 struck Baja just like we were expecting. Now let's go pull the 4.2 right up here in northeast California, northwest Nevada, right at the state line. You go watch the earthquake forecast. We were talking about this location, seeing renewed activity, reaching upwards into the 4 to 5.0 range, and I'm still looking for activity offshore. This is just the start. This is the first day. But I think it's worthy of note at this point to show you how much activity is striking. We're going to get into the rest of the earthquakes internationally in just a second. But first things first, United States, most of my viewers are here. Let's show you what's going on. This is northwest Nevada, right at the California state line. Covered this area at length in the past. You'll have to go back and watch several other videos to get up to speed on why the earthquakes are striking here. We have a fault zone. And as you can see, I've got marked on the map here multiple other earthquake swarms that have struck in the 4.0 range over the last several months. 5,000 or more earthquakes struck right in here. Not all of them marked, obviously, only a few of the swarms I have marked. But just like what we were looking at over to the east in southeast in Arizona, we have going on up here in northwest Nevada, only much older. Now you saw those rounded edges on those old lava flows. That's exactly what we're looking at here, only much older. Here's Bittner Butte. Now the butte top is here, the old remnants of whatever undersea cone was there. And we have our old basalt flows all around here. So here's one here. You can make out the edges along the edge of the old flow. And I urge you guys to come in and check these out. It's really interesting to see. your old basins, of course, several of them are volcanic in nature, not that there, but those old lake beds were formed a long time ago when this was all underwater, and these volcanoes formed underwater as well. We have Blowout Mountain over here just across the county line. Okay, Blowout Mountain. Look this up. You guys will find that this did blast a long time ago, and this is, of course, the remnants of that blast. And the old flow is weathered down over time. You can barely even make it out. Now, why is this significant to what's going on down in Arizona? Well, right across this mountain ridge, look what's over here. See Medicine Lake? Let's just zoom in here and show you guys. We'll start here. I've shown this in past several videos as well. I'm going to put a link down below where I go in depth into this location, specifically Medicine Lake. But you might say, oh, that looks like some kind of rock flow. This is lava. Okay, no trees on it. Just a few hundred years old, possibly. And we can go up here to the very top. We've got Glass Mountain and Medicine Lake. All of these are different craters. Okay, one, two, three. I mean, you could count these all day long. There's several hundred going back up into the backwoods, backcountry. Of course, this is an old lava flow as well. One here, here, here. You can make out the edges on all the old ancient flows. Got another few over here. They're even mining this out. East Sand Butte. Can make that out. The igneous rock there. Your reds and your blacks making up these old cinder cones. And we go further to the east and we have more of the same, just like what we're looking at everywhere else, only much older, of course, much more weathered over time. High nitrogen content, aiding in tree formation and growth on these very old flows, several thousand, if not more, years old. Now, this volcanic field goes all the way over here, and it terminates down here, basically, where this Dome Mountain is. Round Mountain, I should say. Okay, where Round Mountain is where the volcanic field terminates. It goes further down to the south, where it's met up with other volcanic fields. Okay, let's just zoom in and show you. Okay, and there we go. Timbered Crater. And yes, these are lava flows. Overall, it shows you that now we have not just one volcanic center down here, but now we have two showing earthquake activity. And look at it, 4.2, 2.8, 3.1, 3.4, all in the last 24 hours. The 3.4 down here to the south. So really, we have two 3.4s. We have the 3.0 all the way over here in New York, which struck below a water reservoir at 13 kilometers. Let's go ahead and pull the coordinates on this for my East Coast viewers who don't normally see earthquake activity. Guys, we were expecting this to strike your area. Why? Because of the other earthquake activity which struck over this past week on the West Coast, 5.5, 4.2, all of these earthquakes out here to your west pushed the craton up your way. The craton is the plate. Pushed the edge of the plate up your direction, and that caused displacement in your location. Now, let's get these coordinates, put them in on Google Earth, and go show you what's there. This is kind of troubling to see because if we see any more earthquakes strike the spot, we're going to have to worry about what actually resides on top of the earthquake epicenter. So we'll zoom in on this location in eastern New York State, just several miles west of New York City, obviously, out here. But you can see where it struck. Okay. Let's get the name on this. County Road Campground. I wonder if we have some photos of the area. See if that'll help. Okay. Blenheim Gilboa Upper Reservoir. Well, there we go. And it's 13 kilometers below there. And you can see, obviously, it's up here on a hilltop above a river. So, if we see any more earthquake activity strike this location, the people downstream really need to be on watch of a possible, I don't want to say it's going to happen, but you know that if a large earthquake were to strike or any kind of movement were to happen at this dam that holds this thing up here on the hilltop, that this would flow downstream. And look at the cities downstream. Okay, so we won't get too much into that. Just wanted to show you that's where it struck. So really quick, let's get into this internationally. You can see here on Earthquake 3D, these earthquakes raised high off the globe. Longtime viewers already know this. New viewers, let me just quickly explain. The higher these are off the planet, the deeper they are into the Earth. You can see there's four earthquakes here, two of them right on top of each other, raised high off the planet. This is deep below the plate in the West Pacific. Now, when I made my last video, there was only one. Now there's been three additional deep earthquakes all around the West Pacific, from Japan down south. You can see the 5.2 that struck in central Indonesia, and of course two back-to-back, different 4.0, 4.7, 4.4 earthquakes below Fiji. This means the whole West Pacific now has displaced underneath in the asthenosphere, and that's just a fancy term for the semi-melted magma below the plate. Whenever we see the deep movement, we usually see shallow follow-up movement in the areas adjacent to the deep movement. So this pretty much puts a target in two different areas, on Japan and down here in Papua New Guinea. Over the next 7 days, we have to watch for at least two magnitudes higher than the largest earthquake here. So we have a 5.2. This takes us up into the mid 6, low 7 magnitude range in the next 7 days. Again, in the adjacent silent areas. So I said I would do an update if there was additional deep movement that struck, and it has struck in folds. So we need to be on watch over the next 7 days, guys. This activity is no shock to me, because we already started to see it build up last week with the 8.3 down here in the Southeast Pacific in Chile. Of course, as we said, that's not a termination event. We're going to see a ramping up now that this unrest event has kicked into full swing. We see it happen in stages. And guys, just as I'm talking to you now, another 2.9 magnitude earthquake just struck Arizona. This is very rare. Kachina Village. Let's get the coordinates on this again. Let's just make sure that this is an exact matchup. To see a swarm strike north central Arizona at this volcanic field, I just can't believe it just is happening here on the screen live. Let's just go ahead and turn off the picture so this will load up quicker. Let's just back this out ever so slightly. Oh yeah, okay. Here's the earthquake epicenter, and look, we have a actual butte right here, butte tank. They have tanks out here, but you can make out the edge of the old butte. We'll zoom in. And the old flow there. Wow. And we'll back this out ever so slightly, and there's Arsenal Volcano just to the northwest by a few miles. We'll let that load. Of course, here's the San Francisco Volcanic Field. This is where we saw the volcanic plume a few months ago, where they smeared me on the media for seeing a plume. I just can't believe that they did that to me. But anyways, that's where this earthquake swarm is now striking. Now we have two that struck this location. And of course, I haven't mentioned the one single fracking earthquake that happened over the last 24 hours here in central Oklahoma. I don't have to show that to you guys. You guys already know what's there. If you don't know what's there, please go watch my other videos, which I will link down below to, by the way. And let me just finish this video by telling you guys, have an earthquake plan ready and be prepared just in case. Don't be scared, be prepared. It's just an old motto that I've been using for a long time. If you know where earthquakes are going to strike, it becomes way less scary, quote unquote, to know when they're going to strike and how big they are. You won't be shocked if you see a shakeup on the West Coast if you're watching the other activity that's happening internationally and in adjacent areas to you. So guys, much love, be safe.